spot. I didn't get to where I am by talking about myself to the likes of you, or anyone else for that matter. Where is she? What's going on? Talk to me, buddy. What? You fought an army of vamps with magic. You've walked in the shadow world in anima form. You've talked to statues and run with fairies. So what's so weird about a grown man talking to a teddy bear? Emma's in danger. She wouldn't have sent the little guy if she wasn't. It means she was scared. And now she's vanished. This thing is all about her. All of it. She's the reason I'm here. The reason we're all here. As long as she's in danger, you and me, we're on the same team. When the mutants attacked our operations at the breach, I helped Emma get away. Her and the top brass, the Smiths. I couldn't follow. I had to go back, try and salvage what I could, prepare the evacuation. These fucking mutant vamps aren't making it easy. But with your help, though, I can get that bird ready to fly. As soon as I find Emma, our key asset, it's all about saving her. She's gone. But she's not dead. I'd know. He would know. We have to find her. We have to save her. In my dreams, when the bear talks, that's what he says. The world depends on it. Call me crazy, but I think the bear's right.
Additional assignment received. Initializing.
Hello? That was some solid work up there. I'm impressed. We're all set for evac, as long as... No word. I've been to the safe house a dozen times, trying to make sense of it all. That place had top-of-the-line wards, the best magic money can buy and Orochi facilities can manufacture. It was sealed tight. And Emma... I know she's capable of... walking. Anywhere. From the state of the house, I'd say something found its way through. And that's just... not... possible. We're partners now, so it's time to level with you. Can't really tell you much about the breach. I'm a soldier, not a scientist. I just know it's vitally important to a lot of people, and that it has something to do with Emma. I can tell you there's a lot more to all of this than a bunch of bloodthirsty vamps and their crazy queen. They were released for a reason, by someone with their eyes on the breach, and on Emma. I've done the best I can. I've got talents, but I'm not stupid. I'm not gonna go sticking my head where it don't belong. You got a better shot than me to scope around for information, and maybe find out what's really going on here. And hopefully, deal some real damage. You know, you may not trust me yet, but think about it like this. Femme's best friend trusts me. Can't be all bad, right? I've been watching you.
Quick access inventory updated. Quick access inventory updated.
Hiya. Before it all started, this second life of mine, I don't mean the rehab or the parties after, the drugs, bad boys and rude girls. I mean morning light, youth meetings and sermons, spreading the new message. Before then, I would dream of floating in warm water, in the Adriatic, perhaps. My parents summered there when I was a little girl, buoyed by the waves, feeling safe and calm. Now I have dreams of a cold sea, Nowhere I've ever been to. And I'm sinking. Slowly sinking. I'm not afraid of drowning, but I know something is there beneath me. Down in the salt and the dark. I'm not sure it's a good feeling. Does that not sound like a nightmare? The last time I was in these mountains, I can't even have been a teenager. Nothing seemed wrong with the world then. Maybe boredom. Of course, it wasn't really that way, but a child doesn't care. On clear nights in the Carpathian spring, you could look up and see right out to the edge of the galaxy. The bright lines of shooting stars. My cousins would ask, what do you think's looking back at us? There are no clear skies anymore. No more wondering questions. Just the grey and the blood and the dread. Would you tell me something good can ever happen again? I don't even care if it's a lie. Oh, you need to leave before...
Friends of yours or friends of friends?
No, yes, from Bucharest.
I really don't care. You're the socialite, Rada. So socialize.
What should I tell him?
Anything you want. What harm could it do? Really ask yourself, what harm could it do? It's too late to save anyone.
Do you dance? The others went back to their cabins. I haven't seen any of them for so long, it feels like days. But that's just me. I lose count of how things come and go. The days, the others, the midnight visitors. All the things we've done. Markard came to speak to us at the castle. Before. He told us we'd be close to salvation here. Close to benediction. And that whatever sacrifices we had to make would bring us closer to the light. To the rising sun and the new dawn. They frighten me. These people aren't my friends. My parents made me take the morning light personality test after I got out of the hospital. That time feels so far away now, and so very small. A view from space where all around is black. I fear we will all be swallowed by darkness soon. I hope you stay.
Thank you.
I know you from somewhere. No? Have you been to the castle? It was the summer home of my relatives, ones who donated much to the morning light. Now the castle belongs to them. Sorry. Belongs to us. It was why we came here, I thought, to gather the faithful. I guess you could call it a revival meeting, to worship and embrace the rising sun, the new dawn, to burn away the past in the fierce glow of the morning light, to...
Rada, medicate yourself.
Yes, of course. The castle was meant to be unoccupied during winter, but it wasn't empty. Not at all. One night, after the daily gathering and invocations, the morning light service, I went off on my own down below, and I saw ritual, chanting, blood offerings to the Queen of the Night, pale gown, pale skin, pale jewels, pale teeth, a night of teeth.
I should have read the fine print. Not to be taken with alcohol may cause hallucinations, anxiety, and mood changes. Any anxiety or mood changes, Rada? Don't believe everything you overhear.
I hope you stay safe from my dreams.
Additional assignment received. Initializing.
Thank you.
Special assignment received. Initializing.
The first dream is always at the playground. I left this memory for you. I knew you'd come. I knew you'd find it. I think this one's a barn. We passed by one just like it when they brought me here. We were escaping the abyss, the breach. It's what they call what's in the mountain, in the chasm. I'm used to having dreams about things that have been or are or will be. I'm not so used to having my dreams come to life. Finally, there's a church. I've never been. If there is a god, I don't need to go there to talk to it. I can probably talk to the god inside my head. It's how I talk to everything. That thing is in all of them. The sickly thing. It's been sent to take me. Usually the dreams pass once I've seen them. Not this one.
Quick access inventory updated.
Tremble in fear. Invite paralysis.
It's been 2 days since Julia was exposed to the corrupted anima. And while we've been able to slow down the infection, it's still spreading. We've attempted injections of undiluted, farmed anima, but so far, we knew the risk was high, going to the hot springs for samples, but it was a risk worth taking. With such a high concentration of pure corrupted anima, pure filth, we couldn't afford to pass it up. Emma.
She's dreaming. They are not good dreams.
What do you... Do you see anything?
Oh, yes. Everything. The black dreams are inside her. And they are not just whispering. They're shouting. She's very strong. She's very brave. I know she doesn't like me, but...
She likes you.
Please, Winston. I know what she thinks of me. I'm just a lab rat in her head. You care. I don't blame her. She believes she's doing the right thing. You all did.
I'm sorry.
No. You're not.
I'm not confident she'll make it. The exposure was minimal, but in this form, it doesn't take much. If I could only get back out there, collect more samples, I might be able to distill it, make sense of it. The equipment is ready, everything is ready. But those creatures guarding the site are a hell of a lot worse than the vampires and half-breeds and shapeshifters. Without armed escort, it's futile. I'm also having dreams. Emma remains unaffected. She's resistant to the corruption, and not only that, she can fight it, destroy it. Her anima is massively elevated and extremely active. It's unlike anything we've seen before in any of our subjects. It's fascinating. I need to find a way to use that. She might be our final hope.
Quick access inventory updated.
The nightmares are... they're getting worse. A lot worse. Emma. I mean the subject. Emma. Emma is reacting strongly to the psychic disturbances at the site. We've been taking readings at the ruins and have confirmed there is a high degree of spectral noise emanating from what we believe to be dense subterranean pockets of corrupted anima. In layman terms, filth.
Sordes. Tenebra.
What's that?
Her sensitivity appears to be growing, and she's started picking up on everything that...
Jesus!
Tell them to stop digging!
Who? Who's digging?
The soldiers. Please, you need to stop them. The eagle killed them all. But they're still there, and they're not getting any peace. They're in so much pain, I can feel it. I can hear them screaming inside. They dug too deep.
This is a recurring theme. It appears to directly pertain to excavations at the baths. Before the breach, we found evidence of activity by Roman legionnaires around 100 AD. They were trying to reach the engine. They were way off, but close enough to be affected.
Too deep.
As far as we can tell, before the Romans were able to reach the veins, they were all slaughtered. We have to assume by some outside agency.
Sleep now.
If we can get an accurate reading of the signals that Emma's receiving...
Too deep.
It would really benefit our research.
You have no idea where she is.
She vanished again. Fuck! I told you we need to restrain her.
She's a child, Julia, a child. We can't treat her like... Oh, damn it. We have a report scheduled. We'll just edit out the bits that... Emma, the subject, she's taken a walk. Again. She'll be back. The outpost is still radio silent. It's been 10 days. I think it's clear they didn't make it. But we haven't been able to verify this, given the circumstances. The camp is surrounded by that new species they were doing tests on.
They were gathering data about the filth and its effect on the mountain creatures.
We're probably the only ones left.
The last report arrived 3 days before the attack, but the data was lacking in detail and it was inconclusive. I believe there may be more data on site, but it's a risky endeavor, given our situation.
It might be worth it. We need to understand what's happened, and there might be answers in the data. It could be the key to everything. The breach, Ground Zero, the filth, Emma... Everything that... Emma!
Where the hell have you been? Come here!
Ow! Ow! Stop it!
You know you're not allowed to...
Ow!
Emma, what are you... Emma? Emma!
They're coming to the surface. We can't hold an exposed position. Orochi Corps says our odds are strategically better at the old power plant.
Hello, Liddy.
Jesus Christ. What the fuck are you doing here?
What I always do.
Getting in my fucking way? Taking what doesn't belong to you? What do you want?
What you took from the Red Hand base. I've been keeping an eye on it, figuring you'd be thinking the same thing I was thinking. I want it. And this isn't Moscow, Liddy. This time, I have the gun.
Fuck you.
Really? What is it with all the cursing today? Last time I heard so many fucks coming out of your mouth, you had a me at the end of each and every one. And I like to think of it as reappropriation, not theft. You're the thief, Liddy. You always were. Even before selling out to the Phoenicians.
Like you have the moral high ground here? Did you even ask yourself what your people were up to out here? And the girl, don't tell me there's any possible justification for that. Fuck you, though, because I don't have whatever it is you think I have, and if I did, I'd take the bullet before I gave you the satisfaction.
The bullet would give me satisfaction.
Right. Did you already forget what happened in Khartoum? Do I need to remind you?
I'm not the one with the selective memory. I seem to remember someone saying she'd never harm me, never double-cross me, never stop loving me.
The only thing I remember is kicking your ass. The famous ghost, bested by a Phoenician agent. Not your proudest moment. Besides...
That's the girl I fell in love with. Always going for the balls.
Fuck!
You. I know. I know. Go ahead. You've done it once before. You can do it again. You don't have what I'm looking for? Fine. I'll leave you alone.
Yeah. Run away. It's what you always do. See? I'm not the only one with the selective memory. You never showed up in Bangkok. I took you for dead. And so I went to New Carthage.
Bye, Liddy. I'll see you around.